Professor Dave here. Let's talk about potassium permanganate.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
So we're already familiar with potassium permanganate as an oxidizing agent, and we've seen what it can do with alcohols, primary alcohols, secondary alcohols, and aldehydes as well. So now let's look at what potassium permanganate can do to oxidize alkenes. And there's actually two different ways this can go, dependent largely on the temperature. So we're going to look at cold and hot conditions. So first, let's take a look at the cold conditions here. And actually, what's going to happen? So we've got cyclohexene, and we've got potassium permanganate in basic conditions. So we've got sodium hydroxide there. And what this is going to achieve is a syndihydroxylation. This is the permanganate ion, and so it's actually very similar to the addition reaction we already know for syndihydroxylation using osmium tetroxide, right? OSO4, we already know how to do that. And the reason that's a syndihydroxylation is because both of the oxygens that are being delivered to the molecule are coming from the same molecule. So it has to kind of lower down, and it just delivers both oxygens. So actually the permanganate ion is going to do exactly the same thing. We've got two oxygens that are being delivered to the molecule. So we're going to get this syndihydroxylation resulting in this vicinal diol. So just remember, if you're making flashcards, which I highly recommend if you're trying to memorize what certain conditions do, what kind of transformations they promote, when you see potassium permanganate operating on an alkene, if conditions are cold, very important, that's going to be a syndihydroxylation. You're going to get that vicinal diol, exactly like this, just like that. So now, with hot conditions, it's just a little bit trickier. It enhances the oxidizing ability of potassium permanganate. So we've got potassium permanganate this time in acidic conditions. So we've got acidic conditions, just generic acid, H3O+, and remember the triangle means heat. We're going to cook it up a little bit. So we've got our same substrate, cyclohexene. What's going to happen is this going to add, just like we know, and so we've got this intermediate right here, and then this is actually going to cause this carbon-carbon sigma bond to, I've actually rotated this, sorry about that, so just pretend this pi bond was there. But so this is going to cleave right here. This will go to the manganese atom, and then, so this sort of cyclization of sigma electrons is what's going to happen, and it's going to break this ring apart, right? This carbon-carbon sigma bond is actually going to cleave. And so we've opened up that ring. And once protonation occurs, we can see that we've got two aldehyde functional groups, okay? So we've popped that ring open, and we've got the carbons that were participating in the pi bond are now aldehyde carbonyl carbons. But however, we know that potassium permanganate, it's still in solution, and it's a pretty strong oxidizing agent. We know that potassium permanganate can take a secondary alcohol, can oxidize a primary or secondary alcohol, but also an aldehyde, right? So aldehydes are going to get further oxidized. This is a generic symbol for oxidation in the presence of potassium permanganate. So we're going to get all the way to the carboxylic acid. So just remember, in such a situation, right, these carbonyl carbons were the carbons that were participating in the pi bond. And so what happens is we cleaved them, and notice that if we cleave, these would each be considered primary carbons. And so you're going to take those primary carbons, and you're going to take them all the way to the carboxylic acid functional group level. So that's how that one is going to go. But because of that, we need to look at what is going to happen with carbons of other substitution. And so let's say we have these two carbons, right? This is very similar, but we've added some methyl groups right there. Okay, so what happens there? We're going to cleave that all the same, right? The first pi bond goes away when the permanganate ion coordinates, and then the sigma bond goes away when the ring opens up. But what we're left with is we're going to be left with ketones, right? This is going to be a diketone, a dione, right? Because here we had two aldehydes which could be further oxidized to get to the carboxylic acid. But here we're left with ketones, and potassium permanganate is not going to be able to oxidize these further. It's not going to break carbon-carbon bonds, right? So we're going to be left with a diketone, again, same conditions. And then lastly, just one slightly different situation. Let's say we have a terminal alkene. So we have an alkene at a terminus, or basically we've got two protons at the, right? We've got two hydrogen atoms on the other side. So this time, when that cleaves, instead of what would be left as a primary carbon or what would be left as a secondary carbon, right? When this cleaves, this carbon is connected to two others, so we're going to consider it a secondary carbon briefly. Here we're left with a methyl carbon. It's that carbon and no other carbons. And in such a case, that's going to become CO2. So this carbon here is going to become the carbonyl carbon in this ketone, and then this one is going to be the carbon in CO2. Okay, so with the hot acidic conditions, it's going to be a little bit trickier, but what we know is we're going to cleave the alkene, right? We're going to cleave that double bond, both the pi bond and the sigma bond. So we're going to open that up, or if it was a linear molecule, we would pull the molecule into two fragments. And then you look at the two carbons that were participating in the pi bond. So if those two carbons would end up being primary carbons, that is going to produce carboxylic acid functional groups. If those two carbons end up being secondary carbons, that is going to produce a ketone, right? We have a dione here. And then if that carbon ends up being a methyl carbon, that is going to produce CO2. So that is a summary of some of the oxidative abilities of potassium permanganate in the context of alkenes, both in the cold conditions and in the hot conditions. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.